Valentine's Day occurs every February 14th. Across the world, chocolates, flowers, and gifts are exchanged between loved ones in the name of Saint Valentine. But who is this mysterious saint and where did these traditions come from? Let us find out about the history of Valentine's Day, right from the ancient Roman ritual of Lupercalia that welcomed spring to the card-giving customs of Victorian England. The history of Valentine's Day and the story of its patron saint is shrouded in mystery. We do not know that February has long been celebrated as a month of romance and that Saint Valentine's Day contains vestiges of both Christian and ancient Roman tradition. But who was Saint Valentine and how did he become associated with this ancient rite? The Catholic Church recognizes at least three different saints named Valentine or Valentinus, all of whom were martyred. One legend says that Valentine was a priest who served during the 3rd century in Rome. In the year 270 AD, Rome was battling bloody conflicts on all fronts and the Emperor Claudius II was having problems keeping his legions replenished. Claudius knew that because of emotional attachments, married soldiers were not as valiant or vigorous on the battlefield as their unattached brothers. He issued an edict outlawing marriage. Love-struck young Christians appealed to the priest Valentine, who duly obliged. Saint Valentine realized the injustice of the decree, defied Claudius, and continued to perform marriages for lovers in secret. When Valentine's actions were discovered, Claudius ordered that he be put to death. Few others insist that it was Saint Valentine of Tournai, who was a bishop, was the true namesake of the romantic holiday. He too was beheaded by Claudius II outside Rome. Stories also suggest that Valentine may have been killed for attempting to help Christians to escape harsh Roman prisons where they were often beaten and tortured. According to one legend, an imprisoned person actually sent the first Valentine greeting after he fell in love with a young girl who visited him during his confinement. Before his death, it is alleged that he wrote her a letter signed "From Your Valentine," an expression that is still in use today. Although the truth behind the Valentine legend is questionable, all the stories emphasize his appeal as a sympathetic, heroic, and most importantly, romantic figure. By the Middle Ages, Valentine became one of the most popular saints in England and France. While some believe that Valentine's Day is celebrated in the middle of February to commemorate the anniversary of Valentine's death or burial, which probably occurred around 270 AD, others claim that the Christian Church may have decided to place Saint Valentine's feast day in the middle of February in an effort to Christianize the pagan celebration of Lupercalia. Lupercalia was a fertility festival dedicated to Faunus, the Roman god of agriculture, as well as to the Roman founders Romulus and Remus. This festival was also celebrated at the same time around Valentine's Day. To begin this festival, Roman priests would gather at a sacred cave where the founders of Rome, Romulus and Remus, were believed to have been cared for by a she-wolf. The priests would sacrifice a goat for fertility and a dog for purification. They would then strip the goat's hide into strips, dip them into the sacrificial blood and take to the streets, gently slapping women and crop fields with the goat hide. Far from being fearful, Roman women welcomed the touch of the hides because it was believed to make them more fertile in the coming year. Later in the day, according to legend, all the young women in the city would place their names in a big urn. The city's bachelors would each choose a name and become paired for the year with his chosen woman. These matches often end in marriage. Lupercalia survived the initial rise of Christianity but was outlawed at the end of the 5th century when Pope Galatius declared February 14th as Saint Valentine's Day. It was not until much later that the day became definitively associated with love. During the Middle Ages, it was commonly believed in France and England that February 14th was the beginning of birds' mating season, which added to the idea that the Valentine's Day should be a day for romance. The English poet Geoffrey Chaucer was the first to record Saint Valentine's Day as a day of romantic celebration in his poem Parliament of Fools in the year 1375. Valentine greetings were popular as far back as the Middle Ages. The oldest known Valentine still in existence today was a poem written in 1415 by Charles, Duke of Orleans, to his wife while he was imprisoned in the Tower of London. Several years later, it is believed that King Henry V hired a writer named John Lydgate to compose a Valentine note to Catherine of Valois. Cupid is often portrayed on Valentine's Day cards as a naked cherub launching arrows of love at unsuspecting lovers. But the Roman god Cupid has his roots in Greek mythology as the Greek god of love, Eros. Accounts of his birth vary. According to the Greek poets, Eros was a handsome immortal who played with the emotions of gods and men using golden arrows to incite love and to sow aversion. Basically, he was seen as a villain who used love to bring sorrow to gods and men. It wasn't until the Hellenistic period that he began to be portrayed as the mischievous, chubby child that we see on Valentine's Day cards now. An excavation of a Roman catacomb in the early 19th century uncovered remains that are believed to be those of Saint Valentine. In 1836, Father John Spratt from Ireland gave a wonderfully petrifying sermon in Rome. Pope Gregory XVI was so moved that he gifted a golden casket containing St. Valentine's remains to the church in Ireland. Since then, the remains have been displayed in Whitefriars Street Church. Parts of his remains are also kept in few other countries of Europe, including France. On this day, love seekers come to his shrine to place petitions. Valentine's Day is now celebrated all around the world. In Great Britain, Valentine's Day began to be popularly celebrated around the 17th century. By the middle of the 18th century, it was common for friends and lovers of all social classes to exchange small tokens of affection or handwritten notes, and by 1900, printed cards began to replace written letters due to improvements in printing technology. Ready-made cards were an easy way for people to express their emotions in a time when direct expression of one's feeling was discouraged. Cheaper postage rates also contributed to an increase in the popularity of sending Valentine's Day greetings. Today, Valentine's Day is the second largest card-sending holiday of the year after Christmas. Women purchase approximately 85% of all Valentines. For many couples, Valentine's Day is an important date on the calendar to celebrate their love by taking a romantic trip, going out for a nice meal, or exchanging special gifts. For others, it is an expensive and hollow annoyance, especially manufactured for the benefit of restaurants, jewelers, and the card industry. India is well known as a culture filled with ancient traditions. The Hindu culture contradicts many of the Western world's ideals. Valentine's Day celebrations are known to clash with India's conservative religious background. It has only been in the most recent years that Valentine's Day has become widely recognized in India. Valentine's Day, a key day in the commercial calendar, sends hearty purchases into frenzied splurges on cards, flowers, chocolates, and every kind of love token. Valentine's Day is increasingly becoming a huge draw for business in India. Last year, rose growers exported flowers worth $270 million around the world. While corporate employees and older generations of 30 plus years spend anything between 1,000 rupees to 50,000 rupees on Valentine's Day, the younger generation from 18 years to 30 years are expected to spend between 500 to 10,000 rupees. In 2015, it was seen that the rural Indians were more prone to spending money on this occasion of love rather than urban Indians. In 2015, rural Indians' spending increased by 22% on Valentine's Day compared to 20% increase for urban Indians. Online mode of shopping is more preferred compared to offline shopping. In recent times, personalized gifts have become the most popular gift item for Valentine's Day, with chocolates being the second. The other two preferred gift items are accessories and experiential gifts such as holiday trips, movie, spa, romantic dinner, etc. The newest trend among Indians is adventure sports and offbeat holiday destination. Instead of candlelight dinners and spas, couples are now choosing destinations such as Dharamshala, Manali, Kerala, Goa, Dalhousie and Udaipur for a short vacation, or adventure sports like quad biking, snorkeling, sailing trips, bungee jumping, zip lining, windsurfing, seaplane tours, scenic self-drives, etc. Around 40% people feel that it is very important to receive a gift on Valentine's Day. Around 20% people begin the Valentine's Day planning a month ago, whereas almost 30% people start planning a week before Valentine's Day. Expectedly, more than 50% of them take to online shopping for selecting their Valentine's Day gifts. Well, love is in the air. We might as well get used to that. Thank you for the support. This is Nisha PS.